Here's a look at the top 10 plays from this season in the NHL.
Ovechkin into space. A shot. Score! Two zip caps. The 30th of the season for the 18th time in Alex Ovechkin's career.
That's the thing about Alex Ovechkin. If he could be quiet all night, he just needs one opportunity. Huge goal for Ovechkin. As you said, his 30th of the year.
Nobody's done it 18 times with 30 goal seasons until Alex Ovechkin right now. Radish across, Kucherov the point. Nikita Kucherov joins NHL royalty. 100 assists. Only the fifth ever to do it.
And there it is. Kucherov joins McDavid, Lemieux, Orr, and 11 times for the great one. Marvelous. And right to his main man in the high slot. Point has had two chances. This one he puts off the post and in the net. Fans are going crazy here. This is a great moment here. Only the fourth forward in the history of the game to do so. Wow.
This is now the worst goal differential by an NHL club since the 94 Senators. McDavid walks in, defense. There it is! 100 assists! Connor McDavid setting up Hyman's 54th goal! The century mark!
Yeah, everybody in here knows, and rightfully so, the fourth person to do it in the NHL history. To 100 assists, he joins Wayne Gretzky, Bobby Orr, and Mario Lemieux. Gretzky did it 11 times. I know you heard Craig McTavish talk about it. It's a big deal. Congratulations, Connor, on another unbelievable milestone for yourself and your team.
To the stick side of Binnington, Kucherov plays the rebound for Bedard down low. Bedard! Score! Lacrosse style scores! Unbelievable! Connor Bedard!
Oh my goodness, on the backhand, holy jumping. He scooped that up like a lacrosse player, reversed it in as a right-hand shot, and tucked it by the glove of the goaltender, Binnington. Oh my!
Very quick, deceptive way to do it. For him to do something like that, all the kids watching him, obviously every kid's going nuts. This is the hardest way to do it, I think. Philip Forsberg was the first person to do it using this method. He digs under it with the toe.
Mintyukov brings it back in, drops it off to Zegras. Trevor takes it in behind the net. He scores! A lacrosse goal! Exactly what Alan Lozoff asked for.
Wow!
You know, the thing about Zegras, when he does this and executes it, is he's moving. I've seen a lot of guys try it, but not while they're skating at almost full speed.
Zegras astounded me because he was going so fast. No one's done this move any faster than this, and in his first game back after many games off, to pull this one off, you know, he was fired up.
Svechnikov with it. He'll dance around. He'll travel across, move it. It went off the crossbar. He thinks he had a goal. I think he had a goal. We'll wait for a review if we get a horn.
Beautiful. Lacrosse goal number three.
And Andre, I trust when he points.
What a play. And he's got that stick coming from Peak. Peak's ready for it. This is just marvelous quickness with his hands. Oh, and the fling.
And a save by Lindgren on a shorthanded opportunity. Steal denied from 3 feet out. Here comes Mantha. The other way with Strome. He shoots and scores! It's Strome! It's his second of the game!
Alex Ovechkin gets an assist on the goal by Strome. That is the 1,500th career point for Alex Ovechkin. He becomes the 16th player to reach 1,500 career points.
5 seconds to go. The New York Rangers win the President's Trophy. They're number one in the NHL in the regular season. A shutout for Igor Shesterkin, his 36th win of the season, his fourth shutout this season. And what a year for the New York Rangers. A franchise record, 55 wins, a franchise record, 114 points. And for the fourth time in Rangers history, they have won the President's Trophy.
They've been battling. They battle back in the game. They're battling for these loose pucks. Jarry, he's going for the empty net. Bouncing towards the goal. He scores! You have witnessed history. Tristan Jarry becomes the first goaltender in Pittsburgh Penguins history to actually score a goal.
This one sets up really well for Jarry. Notice how it's just kind of chipped in at the blue line. Jarry catches it early. He's got lots of space. And I'll tell you what, that is dead center, 190 feet down the ice.
What a moment.
Bang. Oh, look at the loft.
The best part is, if we can get back to that, is how he held his catching glove. Some will put it low, but it was interesting how he put his catching glove. It's facing upwards. He found nothing but net right in the middle. That would have won a car.
Across Riley, Marner, and now scores! Austin Matthews has 69! And now the Leafs and Matthews are a shot away.
And we mentioned before about just taking what's available, and another good passing sequence. This time it's Marner over, and you can see Reimer tried to get there as quickly as he could, but this is what Matthews does so well. He can accept the pass and get it away in lightning quick time. And that release point up in the top of the net, Reimer went sliding across to try to get there, but unable to get it because Matthews put it where he needed to, the top third of the net, and listen to this building in anticipation of the rest of his power play.
It's rocking.